What's going on, YouTube? You already know who it is. It's your boy. It's the one and only Mr. NightRider. Mr. This truck right here. Oh, man, goddamn. What the fuck? Oh, hell nah. Today, we're going to talk about it's some shit that I've been wanting to address with y'all. Some shit that I necessarily don't agree with. And it's some shit that I want to put y'all up on game about, right? And you know where I see what's fucking up the trucking industry? Where this shit is going downhill? You want to know what I want to talk about? Racism in the trucking industry. Now, you would think that, being that we all truckers, we all out here trying to make a decent living, and we all got the same CDL in our back pocket, that would pretty much even the playing field to where we all kind of like could get along with each other. So what I mean by racism, I'm not talking about just skin, even though that plays a big part in trucking. Some of the most racist motherfucker you will ever meet is behind that mic somewhere where you can't find them motherfuckers. We all know that, but it's deeper than that. We got Peterbilts, you got W9s. You got W9, we got a Mack, we got an International, we got a Freightliner. And it all goes to hand in hand to say that we all drive a motherfucking truck. We all drive a fucking truck. So why the hell would we be putting down another driver when he driving a truck? He making money. He pulling the trailer. He out there on the road providing for his family just like you. And I don't understand that, and I don't get that. I think that's pretty fucked up. I think that's fucking up the trucking industry. That certain people who hit me up feel like they can't make it to the page because they drive a Volvo. Or they drive a T whatever. They feel like they can't make it to the page because they feel like I don't have that show truck. So this person won't acknowledge me, or I won't make it to this. And at the end of the day, what we about to start doing on the page is acknowledging hard work. Not necessarily always acknowledging the truck. We did that before, and that was cool and all. But we about to start acknowledging the hard work that the individual drivers who drive these trucks put in. So, if you drive a 389, and you got everything that the trucking, up-and-coming trucker would want, versus a motherfucker who drive a Sentry. And if that motherfucker who drive a Sentry putting in more miles than you, putting in longer stretches on the road than you, we're going to start calling that shit out. That's what's going on. We about to start appreciating. We about to stop dividing this shit and giving these lazy old motherfuckers who came in to the industry with money all the props and all the respect for them to turn around and treat the upcoming drivers like assholes. We ain't doing that no more. So that's what I wanted to talk to y'all about. Whether you're black, you're white, you're Mexican, you're Chinese. At the end of the day, we all know Mexicans get busy. Just like the Chinese, the motherfuckers get busy. So we ain't going to, we got to stop this. We got to stop all this racism shit. And trying to, oh, this group right here is pretty much made of whites. And this is pretty much the black group. And this is the Hispanic. This is the Chinese. Hell nah, we all together. We all should be in the same motherfucking circle. If you got something I can help you with, I'ma give it to you. And if you got something to help me with, maybe I could get it back in return. But we gotta stop that, because as truckers, we supposed to be a brotherhood. And it's supposed to be us against pretty much the world. Honestly, we like a distant family. It's supposed to be us against the world. It's supposed to be no funny shit, no weird shit. Because if we don't stick together, they not sticking together with us. They don't give a fuck. They want us to not stick together. So that person could say, fuck that, and I'm going to take that load for 65 cents a mile, versus us all sticking together and saying, nah, we not moving for no less than $2. See, when we not on the same page, we put more money in their pocket, versus if we was on the same page and we stuck together. That's the shit that a lot of people don't think, and they don't understand that. They get rich when we fall out, when we don't stick to the script. That's when they make the most money. So that's just something I wanted to touch on today. I wanted y'all to really think about that and try to help your brother out as much as you can. if you know how to put a fucking filter on for them. Instead of letting these mechanics or these other people come taking it to back to the shop and letting them jerk him. How about helping him out and swapping that shit for him? Save him some money. Save him some money. We got to stick together, man. We got to. If we don't stick together, this industry is going to go down. And that's something I wanted to touch on with y'all. So you already know. Keep the rubber on the pavement and the shiny side up. It's Mr. NightRider. Oh, man, goddamn. And until next time.
Roll on highway. Roll on along. Roll on, daddy, till you get back home. Roll on, family. Roll on, crew. Roll on, mama, like I asked you to do. Kissing mama goodbye.